Computer models are critical for forecasters tracking a hurricane, but as we've seen, those projections can vary greatly. So which models are more reliable? Manolo Morales got some answers. Manolo?
Joe, I learned forecasters look at more than a dozen different projections, and they count more heavily on those that have shown the most accuracy over the last few days.
Known as spaghetti models, each track is a simulation of where the storm is expected to go, and they can vary greatly several days ahead. That's because each track is generated by different computers, and they use varying amounts of information to figure out the storm's path. Over the years, forecasters say no particular model has stood out better than the others.
That's one thing we found out after the 2017 season, is that every hurricane that made landfall in the Atlantic, each of them had a different computer model that verified best.
So forecasters with the Central Pacific Hurricane Center rely more heavily on projections that have been more accurate over the last few days.
Looking at where a hurricane has been and where the different models say it would have been back at that time, you can get kind of a real-time gauge as to what's performing the best.
Bravender says it's best to combine the data from the models that have been more consistent, which can give a good indication of where the storm is headed. That's why there's always a cone of uncertainty. But even with that, it's important to note that the path can still change, just like Hurricane Lane did. With the storm approaching, the city says it has been checking streams and channels and will be clearing out ditches at Pokai Bay, as well as streams in Ma'ili and Ulehava. Hawaiian Electric says it's getting ready to move crews and equipment areas that are most likely to be affected. Hawaiian Telecom says crews are checking generators and could soon begin preparing sandbags and other flood prevention activities. The Board of Water Supply says it has placed generators at pumping stations throughout the island.
The city will hold a briefing at 8 o'clock tomorrow morning. We can give you an update on KHON2.com or our KHON2 news app. Joe.
Thanks, Manolo. The neighbor islands are also preparing. On the Big Island, Punalu'u and Whittington beaches on the South Shore are closed. Maui says it's preparing for flooding. And Kauai's Emergency Management Agency says it will focus on securing areas that were already hit with heavy flooding earlier this year.
This one's got a little bit more variability, and so possibly a larger area that it might impact to Hawaii Island. So, you know, we're kind of looking at the whole island as far, well, a larger part of the island.
So our multi-pronged strategy is we'll be considering things such as pre-deployment of assets, strategies for reestablishing quickly vehicular or roadway access.
We're anticipating flash flooding and coastal flooding. We're asking the public to, you know, look to see if they're in a flood inundation zone, and then to have a plan, you know, where they should go for safety.
If you do not have your emergency supplies ready yet, now is a good time to get them together. You should have enough food and water for at least 14 days, along with other supplies. Discuss an action plan with your family. Walk your property and check for potential flood threats. Prepare your pets and know where the nearest emergency shelters are.